Dear brothers and sisters, we are reflecting on how we have to prepare for Christmas. And here we are standing on the eighth day once again, reflecting on how we can prepare ourselves better. Last quotation today of the prophecy from Malachi chapter 3 verses 1. Messenger of the covenant, see, I will send my messenger who will prepare the way before me. Then suddenly the Lord you are speaking will come to this temple. The messenger of the covenant whom you desire will come, says the Lord Almighty. This prophecy is fulfilled, the coming of John the Baptist as the messenger, the preparing the way of Jesus as depicted in Matthew chapter 11 verses 10 and Mark chapter 1, 2 and 3. Now it is about John the Baptist, and one event I want to bring to your notice today is John the Baptist in the womb of Elizabeth leaping for joy when he feels the presence of his Savior around him. A baby in the womb. He was shouting in the desert later. He was telling people to repent. He was baptizing. That is all later. Look at him now. He's not yet born. He's in the womb of his mother. And he's leaping for joy. He's witnessing from the womb. He's not yet born. He's witnessing. So henceforth, one thing is, if I'm a Christian, I am bearer of Christ. When? Not when something great is done by me later in life. No. Every moment from womb to tomb, all the minutes and hours and seconds that I live, I am supposed to live like a witness for Christ, bearing, rejoicing in his name. I am supposed to point the world towards him. I am the bearer of Christ. I'm a Christian. Christ lives in me. This is what is the definition of every Christian, dear for a brethren. It doesn't matter whether you are educated or not. It doesn't matter from where you come, your caste, color, creed, nothing. If he is chosen you, whichever background you came from, you are supposed to live like a witness of Christ. And that's what John the Baptist was. He was a greatest among the ones born of the women. This is what Jesus talks about him. Because he stood as a true witness from the very time he was in the womb of his mother. He was at this job. From the time where his head was being formed to the time he was deformed by his head being cut off from his body, he was doing one thing, that is witnessing Christ. Standing as a true witness. That's why so many people were behind him. But he was behind Christ. He was not moved when people wanted to make him as the Messiah. Where people were looking at him as someone great. He said, I am not fit enough even to untie his sandals. He knew who he is. Because all his focus was in being witness. How could he survive eating locusts, wild honey? How could he survive in the desert? Because his focus was not his body. His focus was in being a witness. What a beautiful example we have today in John the Baptist. Are we preparing for Christmas? Yes? Then look at him. This is how you are supposed to prepare. Like John the Baptist. Amen.